we want to recognize is your brilliant achievements on and off the field. You're in the Miami Sports Hall of Fame, the Texas Sports Hall of Fame. Someday soon, you'll be in the Pro Football Hall of Fame. But we're here today to tell you, you are a member of the Class of 2021 Houston Sports Hall of Fame. Congratulations on your extraordinary career.
Well, I mean, it's great. It just speaks to the, just the accomplishments and things that I've done throughout my career. I was very surprised. I was not expecting this at all. I thought I was taking my mom to the doctor. So once I saw the sirens and stuff outside, I was just kind of like, what's going on? And, I saw you and I kind of had an idea of what it was about. So, it's a great accomplishment and I'm just excited about it.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage the voice of the Houston Texans, Mark Vandermeer.
Hello. Hello, Texans. I am blown away by the Houston sports star power here tonight. What an incredible evening. A year ago, the Houston Sports Awards honored our founder, Bob McNair, as the McNair family brought professional football back to the city of Houston, starting play in 2002. In 2003, our first inductee would join the organization and give us so many unforgettable Sundays. Now, I've not only been blessed to be the voice of the Houston Texans since the team's inception in 02, I was also the voice of the Miami Hurricanes. And I saw Andre Johnson's first scrimmage as a true freshman in August of 1999. And I'm here to tell you, he looks exactly the same today. And it's pretty depressing. Actually, it's very impressive. Andre Johnson, I was at the microphone when the Hurricanes won the Rose Bowl. And he won the national championship MVP trophy in that game. Almost 200 receiving yards and two touchdowns. The helicopter catch against the Vikings in 04. How about 4th and 10 against Miami in 08? 4th and 10 against Washington in 10. Taking people with him to the end zone in 09 in Arizona. The list goes on. And it says so much about Andre. We see so many former Texans, former teammates of his here today. A suite off to my left and scattered throughout the crowd here for this very special occasion to remember the moments on the field and off. Let's take a look at some of those moments right now.
What does it take to be someone people remember? Someone unforgettable. Maybe it takes humble beginnings. Someone raised by a single mom, being willing to step up and be the man of the house. Maybe it takes knowing what responsibility is, putting in the hard work, having shoulders broad enough to carry the weight of knowing your potential before anyone knew your name. Until.
Spectacular catch by Andre Johnson.
Now you've made it, but how will you be remembered?
25-20, 15, 10.
Will it be for joining an unknown team or for being dedicated to make a difference? For holding nearly every franchise receiving record, being 11th all-time in NFL career receptions and 10th all-time in receiving yards, dominating the field, taking the hits, winning one-on-one matchups every time. Or maybe it's 14 unforgettable seasons. A record 14,185 receiving yards, resulting in 70 career touchdowns, 7 Pro Bowl selections, 5 All-Pro selections. The first ever to be inducted into the Houston Texans Ring of Honor. That iconic number, 80.
Oh my! Touchdown!
Andre Johnson once said, he wanted to be remembered as someone who came in every day, worked hard, and gave it his all, day in and day out. Well, Dre, consider this mission accomplished.
And now to induct Andre Johnson, a man who played his high school football in the area, his college football in the area, and he coached a local professional football franchise, taking the Houston Texans to their first winning season, their first division championship, their first playoff victory. Ladies and gentlemen, a Houston legend, Gary Kubiak.
Thank you, Mark. Hello, Houston. How's everybody doing? This is really cool for me. I grew up in North Houston, and to see some of these faces brings back a lot of great memories. But I couldn't be more proud than I am right now with the opportunity that I'm getting tonight with one of my former players. Let me take you back first. Let's go back to 2010, November 2010 to be exact. Houston Texans and the Tennessee Titans are playing in NRG. I think we have a 20-point lead. I think it's 20-0. There's about 6 minutes left in the game. And I'm standing there on the sidelines, and I hear a voice behind me. It says, Coob. I didn't react. Coob. I turned around, and there was a player standing behind me, and y'all all know who he was. And he looked at me. He said, Coob, I got to do what I got to do. And I said, what the hell is that, Andre? I had no idea. Anyway, we got the ball back with about 5 minutes left. We sent our group out there to kill the clock, basically, and get the game over. So we handed it to Arian. It wasn't a very exciting play. And all of a sudden, the crowd went wild. And I looked, I said, "What? You know, what's going on here?" I looked to my left, and about 30 yards down the field, my man Andre has Cortland Finnegan wrapped up in knots over there, getting after it. But you know what? I thought about that story when I came here tonight because it tells me two things. I want you to know about Andre. Andre was about team first. So before he took care of his business, he made sure his team won. He was about team first. And he was one of the greatest competitors I've ever been around in my life. Quick story. I got started coaching in the National Football League in 1994. My job was a quarterback coach of the San Francisco 49ers. On game day, Mike Shanahan called plays. I was on the field. I relayed them to Steve Young. On that team, we had a pretty good wide receiver. And if we didn't get him involved or get him the ball in about the first 6-7 minutes of the game, he would walk by me, and he'd be about 10 feet away, and he would scream as loud as he could, get me the damn ball. I would say, Shanahan, did you hear that? He goes, yeah, I heard it. That guy was first ballot Hall of Famer Jerry Rice. Some say the greatest of all times. 14 years later, I come to Houston. I didn't know much about the team, but I knew one thing. I had a hell of a wide receiver on that football team. And as a play caller on Sunday, coaching Andre, if I didn't get him involved in the first 6 or 7 minutes of the game, he would come off the field, much like Jerry, and from about 10 feet away, he'd stare a hole right through me. And what that meant was, Kubiak, get me the damn ball. I knew it well. Andre, I see you in that light. I was around him and I was around you. That's the type of player you are. Special player, special competitor. And before I close, I want to pay you the highest compliment that I think I can pay you. They say in life that people have a cross to carry, have a cross to bear. What I witnessed when I came here and I was a head coach for 8 years, I saw you carry a cross for the entire Houston Texan organization. In a day and time where players chase victories, I want to go play for this team. They're better than mine. In a day and time where coaches chase organizations, I want to coach for that team because I got a better chance of being successful. Andre, you stayed right here and busted your butt for your teammates in this city like no other player I've ever seen. And it was special. And you know what, Andre? Let me tell you what. Jerry Rice, a Hall of Famer. And tonight you're being paid a tremendous honor going into the Houston Sports Hall of Fame. But buddy, we're going to Canton someday. Okay? We're going there someday. Good Lord willing, I'm going to be there. All right? So I guess without further ado, I'd like to present to the Houston Sports Hall of Fame, the man with the Hall of Fame stare, one of my favorite players, Andre Johnson.
You can tell everybody, Thank you. I didn't expect this to be like this, especially with dealing with COVID and everything. But just this turnout is truly amazing, just to be around so many great players and so many great athletes here tonight. First of all, I want to thank PNC and the Houston Sports Hall of Fame for, you know, this great turnout and this great event. I'd like to thank the McNair family for drafting me in 2003. I didn't really know what to expect coming here to Houston. Grew up in Miami, played college ball in Miami. And, you know, it was my first time really leaving Miami, you know, coming here to Houston. And the way the city welcomed me, it was truly amazing. You know, I became a Houstonian now. You know, I live here permanently. And, but I'd like to thank Coach Kubiak. When he came here and became my head coach, my career tremendously changed. You know, he involved me so much in the offense. My receiver coach, Coach Kersey, is here. All of my teammates over there, love you guys, man. My agent, Kanard McGuire, I appreciate you so much, man, for everything you've done for me. My mom and my brother are in the back. I love y'all. Thank y'all for all y'all support. My daughter's up here sitting with me in the front. She was probably one of my biggest critics. I'll give y'all a short story about her. She was probably about 6 years old. We were playing the Colts. And I ended up fumbling the ball. It was like a bang bang play. I was going and running a slant route and Vontae Davis hit me. And as soon as I thought it was a drop, but they called it a fumble. And I went to the sideline and I slammed my helmet on the ground. And I didn't realize that it was on TV. They had showed it on TV. So she couldn't come to the game because it was like a Monday night game or something. She had school the next morning. And she called me the next day. She was like, Dad, why did you slam your helmet on the ground? So me being a dad, I'm just like, Kylie, you know, I was upset. You know, I did something wrong in the game, you know, just trying to brush it off. And she just gets hype on the phone. She was like, nah, you cost us the game. You fumbled that football. So she's a huge football fan, man, a huge Houston Texans fan. But, you know, I just thank you all for all y'all support and everything. And thank you.